Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to use Gemini AI API with Golang. So let's get started. So first thing, just Google Gemini AI API. You'll be getting the first link as build with the Gemini API. Just click this, and after this you need to sign in with your Google account and click on this get API key in Google AI Studio. And here you can run and test your text prompts, and if you type something and if you click on this run prompt, it will give you a response from the model. So this is just like a playground. And to the left we'll be having this documentation. Click here, and in this getting started tutorials, expand this, and we'll be having for Golang. So this will have all the instructions how to set up Gemini AI library, as well as making API calls, as well as the demo code. So here you can see. So first thing is we need to add this particular thing, okay, from GitHub. So just copy this and let's begin with the code. So here I'm having a simple .go file, just a main function. I'm just printing test, and I'm having here the output. So now we need to run the init command. It's going to be go mod init main. That's it. And now just run the copied command. That's it. It has been added. So I'll just go to the code now, and this is the entire code, and this is the import statement. So I'll just copy these two, go here, put it inside the import and remove the import thing. Yeah, and next thing is going to be the code. So if I scroll down like this, this is the entire code, and this is for text only input model, which is Gemini Pro model. So we can just literally copy this code, go here and just paste it inside the function. So in this case, since it is just a demo purpose, I'm just handling it everything inside the main function. You can just customize it based upon your use case, okay? And now let's see how we can add our API key. So since this is just a demo purpose, I'm just going to hard code the API key. But in your case, you can just have it in an environment variable, okay? So for getting the API key, just go to that playground, and to the top you'll be having get API key. Click here and click on this create API key option. And for you, this create API key will be enabled in case if you are using it for the first time. For those who it's not enabled, just click on any of your projects and then click on this API key. Copying it, and you can even delete the API key in case if you want to. And I'll just go to the code and I'll just remove this. And within double quotes, let me specify the API key. And if I go here, it's throwing error for log and context, so we also need to import that. So I'll just remove FMT, we don't need it. We can just have log. It's going to be log and context. Yeah, that's it. Now we don't have that errors. So final thing is this response is not used, and we are also having an error for importing this. So for that we need to run the tidy command. It's going to be go mod tidy. Just run this. That's it. After you run it, we won't be getting that errors anymore. Final thing is we need to get this response. We need to print that data from this response, okay? So this is the prompt. I've just changed the prompt to essay on global warming. So this will be given to the model and we'll be getting a response. So that's pretty much it. Just a simple piece of code over here. Here we are specifying the model name. Since it is just a text model, we are using Gemini Pro. In case we want both text and image, we will be using Gemini Pro Vision model. So that's it. So now we need to get this response. We need to break this response, okay? So for that I'm having existing code already. I will just paste it over here. So this is the code that I have to destructure the response and print the contents, okay? So first thing is response, and it has a key called as candidates in the structure. So I'm just destructuring that over here. And after that, under candidate, I'm having the content key. So I'm also destructuring that, and I'm accessing parts over here. So later that I'm just printing it. So I just found it out by somehow clicking on this generate content, and here we'll be having a generate response thing, because this is of type generate response. Here you can see generate content response. So I just searched here generate content response, and later I found it out it has these parameters, and this candidate has another three parameters within that. So this is how I came to a conclusion that this is going to be a thing. And I'm pretty much new to Golang, so in case if you have any other shortcut way of accessing the value present inside response variable, you can just comment it down. But this works for me. You can just, you know, pause the video and type this out. Okay, this is the code. So let me just save it and I will just run it again. So here you can see we have got a essay on global warming. So the code works absolutely fine. You can just try it out, guys. So that's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.